and warm, I think that we shall have a lovely day.
Very, very warm for May.
Eight in the shade, they say.
Just as right,
it almost looks as though the sun had really come to stay.
Amongst the girls, put me amongst the girls. Do me a favor, do you know I'd do the same for you if you will put me amongst the girls. Ooh, the ones with the curly curls, they'll enjoy themselves and so will I if you will put me amongst the girls. Tonight to the lady and gentleman who've come all the way from Norway just to see the show up there. Phraseologically flamboyant, in fulsome, encomiastic eulogies, flaunting preliminarily the player Setter and Mr. Norman Vaughan. But this time, in blarneying buffoonery, Mr. Pat Mooney!
Fantastic. Lovely to see you all. I'm sorry about the suit. It'll be all right when it's ripe. Pat said to Mick, can you count? He says, of course I can. One, two, three, four, five. He says, can you count any higher? He says, yes. One, two, three, four, five.
Dumpty.
Murphy was working on a building site and the slate fell off the roof and cut his ear off. And all the lads are looking on the rubble and the sand and the cement for Murphy's ear. And Rafferty says, "Ear, there's an ear here, Murphy. Is that your ear?" Murphy says, "No, mine's got a pencil behind it." Pat and Mick are in a big pub having a drink and there's a big mirror along one wall. And Pat looks over at the mirror and he says, "Jesus, Mick, there's a fellow over there, the image of you." And Mick looks over at the mirror and he says, "How's that for a coincidence? Look at the fellow beside him." Pat looks over and he says, "Jesus, you're right, I'll get up and get them a drink." And as he stood up, Mick said, "Sit down, I think they're coming over." He was driving Mick down the road in his old car the other day and he went right through a set of red lights. Mick says, "You've just gone through a set of red lights." He says, "Don't panic. Murphy does it all the time." And they went right through the next set of red lights. He says, "That's two sets of red lights you go through. You're trying to kill the pair of us." He says, "Don't panic. Murphy does it all the time." And the next set of lights were on green and he stopped the car and put the brakes on. He says, "You've just gone through two sets of red lights. What are you stopping on the green ones for?" He says, "Precautions. Murphy might be coming the other way." He opened a fish and chip shop and an Englishman walks in and he says, "Fish and chips twice." And Murphy said, "I heard you the first time." He walked into a plumber's. He says, "I'd like to buy a bath." The plumber says, "Would you like a plug with it?" He says, "Why? Is it electric?" God, you're looking gorgeous. He went to France for his holidays, walks in the biggest casino in Monte Carlo. And the governor met him at the door. He says, "Bonsoir, Monsieur Murphy." He had his wellies on, you see, at the time, you know. "Did you wish to gamble?" "I'd like a gamble, monsieur." He says, "Roulette, monsieur?" "Not roulette, sir. I can't count up to 36. He says, "Chemin de fer?" He says, "No, I was at the puck fair last week, sir." "No, no." He says, "Oh, all we have left for you is dominoes." He says, "I like that game. That's the game of the spots, isn't it? Dominoes." He says, "I like that game." He says, "Monsieur, here in Monte Carlo, every spot in the dominoes is 18 carat diamonds. You will like this game." And he sits down with all these millionaire Frenchmen playing dominoes with 18 carat diamond spots. And he's losing all his money. And he's down to his last couple of francs. And he thinks to himself, "I'm not going home broke." And he flicks one of these dominoes into his welly. And he hobbles all the way back to his hotel. And when he got it out, it was a double blank. Joy. Look at the styles here tonight. Where are you all from? Where are you from, love? Where do you come from?
Prestwich.
Prestwich? Oh, yeah? Did you read the papers this morning about Prestwich? They've just done worldwide statistics on women. They found out that 90% of the women of Prestwich are unfaithful to their husbands. How about that? And the 10% who were faithful to their husbands so impressed the Archbishop of Canterbury. He sent them all a letter of congratulations each. Wasn't that nice of him? Wasn't it? Do you know what it said in the letter? Didn't you get one? Oh. Sorry about that. It's been lovely back with you again here at the old... This is lovely, yes, I've been here with you all. I'd like to leave you all with a thought to go home with tonight. Never put off to tomorrow what you can do tonight. Because if you do it tonight and you like it, you can do it again tomorrow, can't you? Good night. God bless you. Thank you.
I must say the hats are orchidaceous tonight. Not very much décolleté. The show is really more millinery than naval, isn't it? Hey. Oscar Ashe said that first. A superlative sibling distillation of coruscating descant and dithyrambic deliquists. Ladies and gentlemen, for your delight, Marietta and Vernon Midgley! Thank you.
joy will say what love is man undying. Life is but a sorrow made a day that love is dead. Oh, gently waft in
when the grapes are purple, Margarita picked the grapes with me. There are silver bells upon her fingers. All the little birds come out to see. Ma, bella Margarita, so beautiful to see. Then, mon appetit, Margarita picking grapes with me. Ting-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling- Grapes with me, Margaret.
think it means? Scintillant, in intriguing, esoteric intrepidity of equilibristic equipoise. Balancing. Chengis!
Thank you.
that twinkling terpsichorean dancing with the feet. Troubadour, Mr. Benny Garcia!
In days of yore before the war, when hearts now old were young, at home each night by firelight, those dear old songs were sung. Sweet melodies, the memories around my heart still cling. That's why I like to hear a song like Grandma used to sing. California, here I come, hey, right back where I started from. Where bowers of flowers bloom in the spring, each morning at dawn, birdies singing, everything is sung, kiss me, say, don't be late. That's why I can hardly wait. Come on and open up your golden gate, California, here I come. Come on and open up your golden gate, California, here I come. Hey! Come on here, come on here, Alexander's ragtime band. Come on here, come on here, it's the best band in the land. He's playing you call like you never hear before, so natural that you want to go to war. It's just the bestest band around. Oh, my honey, land, come on along. Let me take you by the hand up to the man. I said the man who's the leader of the band. And if you care to hear the Suwannee River play in ragtime, come on here, Alexander's ragtime band. And if you wanna hear the Suwannee River play in ragtime, come on here, Alexander's ragtime band. Does your mother know you're out? Cecilia, does she know that I'm about to steal ya? Oh my, when I look in your eyes, something tells me you and I should get together. How's about a little kiss, Cecilia? Oh, just a kiss, you'll never miss, Cecilia. Oh, why should we two keep on wasting time? Hey! Oh, Cecilia, won't you please be mine? Whoops.
Of welcome and perhaps more for the youngest ever performer in this program. Ladies and gentlemen, little Miss Rosa Michelle!
Shoulder, Daddy, turn you. face to the west. It is just the hour the skies turn gold, the hour that mother loved best. The day has been long without you, Daddy. You've been such a while away. And are you tired of your work, Daddy, as I'm tired my play? But I've got you and you've got me, though everything is gone. Those thoughts will all be right. We shall always keep her here in our dreams. Daddy, good night. Daddy, good night.
Thank you very, very much, ladies and gentlemen. And what about that number, Little Rosa? Wasn't that sad, eh? Never mind, because actually I've got somebody here who's just as sad. His name is Orville. He's very shy. I'll get him to turn around and have a look. Will you turn around and have a look?
I can't.
I beg your pardon?
I can't.
You can't?
No.
Why not?
Because they laugh at me.
I don't think they'll laugh after that last song. Look, they won't laugh at you. Look, they're very nice people. Come on, turn around and have a look.
I'll have a look then.
Have a look.
I will too.
Come on. Oh, you see?
They're laughing now.
Oh, they're not.
I heard them.
Yes, I know. But you see, they're laughing.
I heard them.
Yes, I know, but they're not laughing at you.
No.
No, you see, it's because they're on the stage and you came here last time. You had a nice time, didn't you?
Yes, thank you.
That's right. Yes. But if you remember last time we came to this theatre, you had a chip on your shoulder.
I didn't.
You did.
I didn't.
You did.
I didn't.
You did.
You had a chick on your shoulder. Me.
I didn't say a chick. I said a chip.
Oh.
Yes. Now listen, you were watching before in the wings, weren't you?
I got wings.
Yes, I know you've got wings.
I got wings, you know.
Yes, I know.
I got wings, you know.
You were watching. What were you watching?
Little girl singing.
That's right. Did you like her?
Yes.
Did you?
Yes.
And you said that you would like to meet her because she wasn't very happy, was she?
No.
And would you like to meet Rosa?
I get shy when I see Rosa.
What, Rosa Michelle?
No, Rosa, people looking at me. I just get shy.
Look, I'll tell you what. Because she wasn't very happy, so if we bring her on...
Yes.
Well, you can meet her and it'll make you happy and make her happy, wouldn't it? All right.
Right.
So I tell you what, we'll just call her on. Is she Rosa?
Oh, she's there.
All right. Oh, no. Come and sit down here. There you are. Now.
Is she here?
Yes, she's here.
Oh, I book. No, of course you can.
Come on, now, Rosa, this is Orville.
Hello, Orville.
Hello, Oh, I can't. I feel silly.
Look, it's all right. Look, we've got to try and cheer up. Now, she's very, very pretty, you know.
I wish I was pretty.
Well, you are pretty.
I'm ugly. I'm ugly, aren't I, Rosa?
You're not ugly. I think you're lovely.
Oh! You think I'm lovely?
Yes, he is, isn't he? Yes.
There you are.
Oh, thank you.
Now, listen, what were you telling me before?
Rosa, you know, when you sang your song, well, it made me cry.
I made you cry?
Yes.
I didn't mean to.
Well, you did, because you sang about your daddy, didn't you?
That's right.
And I haven't got a daddy.
Oh.
And I haven't got a mummy.
Oh.
And I haven't got a granddad or a granny, and I haven't got any... I haven't got anybody.
Oh.
Keep it up.
No antecedents.
Daddy.
I said no antecedents.
I haven't even got an Auntie Elsie. No.
Oh, dear. Look, we're not doing a very good job cheering Rosa up, are we?
No.
Listen, you two must get together. I mean, you must always remember to smile.
Yes.
Because you've got all the lovely people here. And just remember.
What?
Smile, though your heart is aching.
Yeah.
Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by.
If we
smile through your tear and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness. You've got a hide every trace of sadness, although a tear may be ever so near. That's the time you must keep on trying.
Smile.
What's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile.
Both got your style, but breathy or never fully dressed without a smile. Your clothes may be bold, brotherly, they stand out a mile, but breathy or never fully dressed without a smile. Who cares what you're wearing on Main Street or Savile Row? It's what you wear from ear to ear. Head to toe, that matters. Hey, Hopperman, hey, Dapper Dan, so long for a while, remember you're never fully dressed. Though you may wear the best, you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Ingratiating, in gregarious, from the Latin Grex, legis, garrulity, none other than Mr. Norman Vaughan!
La, 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 la,
great when I went on the stage about 6.5 months ago. 'Cause everybody was so kind to me when they found out that I was a pro. But a fire broke out in my lodgings one night, and the firemen were there instantly. They saved everybody right down to the cat, but they never once tried to save me. I dashed to the window and heard with dismay a big fire brigade captain to somebody say, "He's a pro, he's a pro. He'll do us a turn in a minute or so." I could feel myself cooking. My shirt was alight, so I stood on the windowsill, trembling with fright. The firemen were laughing at me, and I heard someone say down below, "Let him do us a turn, 'cause I don't think he'll burn. He's a pro, he's a pro." Yes, I've played them all. The Palace Halifax. The Savoy Kettlethorpe. The Apothecary's Hall, Runcorn. My grandfather was famous too. You know about grandfather? Oh, my grandfather went back to Marie Antoinette, and my grandmother caught him a couple of times. 40 years of happily married life, and then he died. After 40 years, he died. Oh. And she wanted to get in touch with him. So she went to see all these spiritualists and mediums. And eventually, one Thursday afternoon, she was in the spiritualist and she heard his voice. And she said, "Henry, tell me, what's it like on the other side?" He said, "It's fantastic." He said, "This is the routine. We get up in the morning. We have a light salad breakfast. Then we have a loving all morning. Then we have a light salad lunch. And we have a loving all afternoon. Then we go to bed very early to get ready for the next day." And she said, "Henry, I didn't think they did things like that on the other side." He said, "Other side, I'm a rabbit in Harrogate." Thank you, Bernard. At a swell music hall where I thought I should make such a hit. The band played my music, I dashed on the stage, but a battle was on in the pit. I started to sing, "All That I Ask Is Love." I remember no more after that. All that I asked was love, but the boys up above gave me something more solid than that. I woke up in hospital the following day, and I just recollect hearing somebody say, "He's a pro, he's a pro. And the poor devil looks like one too," said Nurse Flo. The doctor said, "Nurse, there's but one thing to do. We must operate on him to pull him right through." He said, "Nurse, do you think he'd hurt if we starved him for 12 hours or so?" The nurse said, "Have no fears, he's been starving for years. He's a pro, he's a pro."
Once again, the Players Theatre!
Here we are again. It's back to Mac and Tommy, Jack and Joe. When the stop will do it, when the stop will do it.
time to ask Mr. Norman Vaughan to lead the company and yourselves in the last chorus for tonight, down at the Old Bull and Bush. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Norman Vaughan, the entire company, Mr. Bernard Herman, and the entire and indefatigable orchestra.